In this video, I'm going to be finding the value of I naught and V naught using Kirchhoff's current and voltage laws. In the previous example, what we're going to be doing first is we're going to assign current to the branches that have no current. This would be 6 ampere. And this current would have, this branch would have, say, I1. Then we're going to assign polarities to those branches that have no polarity. Now to those resistors that have no polarities. So let's call this positive and negative. So the first thing we can write here is Kirchhoff's current law. And one thing you notice is that this whole line is a single node, because you can simply redraw this circuit like this as a single node, and it will still not have changed the properties of the circuit. So this entire line is a single node. So we can write a Kirchhoff's current law around the node, which would give us six minus I naught minus I naught over 4 minus I1 equals 0. Now, that will give us our first equation. Considering this branch, we can determine the value of I1 using Ohm's law. So we can say that I1 is equals to V naught divided by 8. This will give us 6 minus I naught divided by 4 minus V naught divided by 8 should be equals to 0. So let's call that our third equation. This is our second equation. One thing you don't see at first glance, but you can actually do, is we can rearrange the circuit to look like this. You can just change these two branches and it looks something like this. And you can see that using this circuit, you can write a KVL equation around this loop. Notice that you can only write a KVL equation in a loop that does not contain a current source. So you can write a KVL equation around this source, and that will give us, you're going to have to start from here, and you're going to have KVL equation to be V naught over 8 into 8. Minus 2 I naught, which should be equals to 0. We can solve these two equations together. This equation and these equations can be solved together. We can simplify this equation as five I naught divided by 4 minus V naught divided by 8 No, sorry, plus is equals to 6, which can be further simplified as 10 I naught plus V naught equals 48. Now, solving these two equations, this equation and this equation, as this equation can also be simplified as V naught minus 2I naught equals 0, you can simply say that V naught equals 2I naught. You can substitute this here. That would give us 10I naught equals 10I naught plus 2I naught equals 48. This would infer that 12I naught equals 48. This means that I naught equals 4 and V naught equals 8 volts 4 ampere. Thank you for watching.